Now we'll begin with our third section, circle. So we'll study about the area and the perimeter of the circle. Before we do that, let us study about the circle and the different elements of the circle. So what is a circle? This is the definition of a circle. The definition of the circle is locus of a point. Locus means path. So it is a path of a point which moves in such a way that its distance from a fixed point O. This is the fixed point O, where every line is meeting in this particular diagram. So from a fixed point O, always remains constant at r units. In this diagram, this is the diagram of the circle, and the blue color part is actually the locus of a point. So it is a path traversed by a point such that every point on this path is always at r units from the center O. If you will consider this figure, you will see that every point on this blue color segment is always at a constant distance from the center. This point is also at a constant distance from the center. This point, this point, this point, each and every point. So when you join all such points, that become our circle. Now what is the distance of each and every point on the outer boundary of the circle or the boundary of the circle from the center? That distance is r units, and which is known as, this distance is known as the radius. So what is a radius? Radius is a line segment joining the center of the circle to the point of the circumference, and its value is r. Now in this diagram, which is our radius? The green color part is my radius. It is a line segment which is joining the center and a point on the circumference of the circle. What is the circumference of the circle? See, circumference is the perimeter of the circle. So this blue color part is known as the circumference of the circle. And any line segment which joins the center and the circumference of the circle is known as the radius. And the value is, it is denoted by the r. It can be r meter, r centimeter, r kilometer. So the units of the radius are the units of the length. Now, as we have already done that the circumference is the perimeter of the circle, so this blue color part is known as the circumference of the circle. And the formula to find out the value of this circumference of the circle is 2 pi into r. That means 2 into pi into radius of the circle. Then what is a chord? Chord of a circle is any line segment which joins two points on the circumference of the circle, and it is denoted by the red color line segment in this figure. This is one point, this is another point on the circumference of the circle, and when you join these two points with the line segment, then this line segment is known as the chord. Then what is a diameter of a circle? Diameter is actually the longest chord of the circle, or I can say it is the chord which passes through the center of the circle. Now if you see the black color line segments, this and this, both are the diameter of the circle. It is a chord because we are joining two points on the circumference of the circle, and the chord which passes through the center of the circle is known as diameter. So this is also the diameter of the circle, this is also the diameter of the circle. And the value of all the diameters, or whatever the possible diameters that you can make in a circle, is always same, and their value is twice of radius. Why is it twice of radius? Because if you see in this figure, this line segment can be divided into two parts. One is this part and the other is this part. And both parts are actually the radius of the circle, because they are the line segment joining the center and a point on the circumference of the circle. So r plus r is equal to 2r. So which is my diameter of the circle. Then at last, what is the area of the circle? The formula to calculate the area of the circle is pi r square. That means pi into square of the radius of the circle. Now these two formulas, pi r square and 2 pi r are used to find out the area and the perimeter of the circle, and these are the two most important formulas required to find out these values in a case of a circle. So with the help of these formulas, we'll solve the questions which are related to the circle.